Good evening, all. I have a new box. It's from TID Radio, or TID Radio, however you say that word. Anyway, this just arrived in the mail yesterday. And let's get it open. Pretty thin box. Anyway, here we go. Oh, look at that. It's the new TD-H3. It's manual. Okay. I will have a look through that later on. Let's just put that up there for now. We have a belt clip with a... there's an Allen key with a screw on the end of it. Okay. We have a charging base station. This sits into there. We have a lanyard as usual. Put that there. Like every radio you get, there's the dual band antenna. Oh, a little business card here, some sort of thing. Yep. TID radio so far that I've been working with have been pretty good. Anyway, what do we got here? We have this is. Oh, it's a USB charger. USB... That's USB-C. Good. So that means it's probably got a USB-C. It does. And finally, the radio. Let's get this box out of the way. Well, first things first is it's small. It's a chubby little boy. But it is small. So let's have this opened up. Yeah, look at that. It is very small. Fits in my hand nicely. Nice rounded on the back. Yeah, that's a really small guy. So let's get this antenna on it. Let's have a look at the battery. Ah, right, okay. So, there we go. TID radio TD-H3. And a battery.
Welcome.
Okay. Small display, but it's readable. Seems to have two different bands in the bottom there, one at the top here. Okay, so let's have a look. Have a look at the menu.
Menu.
So you've got the usual. It's the bandwidth, squelched, power saving, steps, backlight, beep. Box, the usual. Yeah, CT, CSSs, scans, scan modes. Not sure. Oh, there's the name, frequencies, busy lock, direction, offset, memory, delete, alarm, seek, Rogers. Two tones, okay. Oh, hopping frequency, hopping RX off. I'm guessing that's to do with the scrambling function, which just jumps the transmission between different frequencies. Reset, sync. Not sure what that is, but I'm sure I'll find out. Let's go through the rest of them. Oh yes, this is the ham version. When I went to the TD's website, there was two versions. There was a GMRS or the ham, so obviously I got the ham one. Breathe lead for a second. Okay, I'm not sure what that is. Mic gain, I got mic gain scramble on off. Okay, so I'm not too sure what that RX one is then. Code off, AM. Oh, what was that? Alright, okay, it's got AM band option, which is currently turned off. PCD. D hold. D. Oh. 200 TX is turned off. 350 TX is turned off. 500 TX is turned off. Oh, okay. How many bands does this thing have then? Y band, squelch. Okay, we're back there again. Right, okay, that's interesting. So, what have we got on the bottom here? We've got the VFO channel.
Frequency mode.
Okay.
Channel mode.
What else do we have? What's that? Oh no, it's not a button. That's just a light. Tone codes. Yep. Okay. What do we got here? It's the bottom button here. Oh, just the light as usual. Okay, next button. It's doing something. What's that saying there? Oh, the bottom button. It's transmitting on the bottom. Oh, is this dual push to talk? Try the top one. Bottom one. Yes, it is. It's dual push to talk. Oh, I didn't realise that. Okay. Let's see what else is on here. We have... Oh, BT. Oh, Bluetooth. That must be to do with the programming, so... It's just a... No. Oh, push and hold. Maybe it's... Ah, look. Oh. Ah, there, look. Bluetooth icons appeared. That must be so you can program it from the OD Master software from your phone. Now it does have... Yep. Oh, okay. There's the USB-C. So I'm guessing that's where you can... Oh, well there's a battery. On the bottom of the battery is USB-C. On the side of the housing there's USB-C. And the usual Kenwood style, I believe that's called. Okay. Well, initial impression is it's not too heavy. In fact, it's actually quite light. But its size, it's really quite small, quite easy on the hand. Okay. Well, that's just a quick unboxing of the new TID radio or TID radio TD-H3. Anyway, I will be back soon with some programming and we'll go from there. Hey, 7-3s, have a good night.